When does Lac du Coron open?
So we open end of April 2016.
And how big is the lake?
Lac du Coron is just under 5 acres. Quite long, quite narrow, loads of overhangs, quite accurate fishing.
Tell me a little bit about where it is.
Right, so Lac du Coron is in the southern tip of the Loire Valley. So far enough south to get sort of really lovely weather from early March till mid-December, but not so far away that you spend too much time travelling. It's just over 4.5 hours from Calais Drive. Obviously less than that leaving from Caen or St Malo, we're talking 3 hours. And obviously if you fly and you get an early flight out, you can be fishing before lunch.
And what about the stock that's in the lake?
Okay, so I won't go into a huge detail, I'll try and keep the answers short and sweet, but the stock have been hand-selected and we've been really picky about the sort of the fish that we're looking for. We didn't just want huge fish, we wanted great big fish that also looked unique and stunning. So there's 3 fish over 50 pounds, loads and loads over 40, and even more over sort of 32, 33. Average weight's going to be sort of between 32 and 35 pounds by the time we open in April.
Is Lac du Coron just to drive and survive?
In the grand scheme of things, you would call it a drive and survive, but it's definitely a very comfortable drive and survive. There's a lodge on site, there's electric, Wi-Fi, toilets, showers, etc. Swims are very comfortable. So yes, technically there's no accommodation on site, but with the lodge it's a very comfortable week's camping.
And what's this different vibe that we've heard about?
The whole different vibe thing is to try and sort of encapture what I love about fishing and what I love about fishing in France. Sometimes places I've been in France are a little bit sterile, sort of all the snags have been removed, it's basically like a golf course around the lake. And that's, you know, that's got its place and a lot of people love that, but I wanted to keep it very natural, mature and overgrown. So on top of that, you've got the whole sort of social, chilled out element of the lake with the built-in barbecues and the lodge and the terraces and things like that to try and, you know, create a great vibe as well as awesome fishing.
That seems a good time to ask about the rules. Are there loads of rules?
No, not at all. Basically, the rules are 99% common sense. I won't go into one by one. Obviously, they're on lacdecoron.com. We haven't put any rules in that I think anyone would sort of take offence to or be surprised at. There's a handful of rules, and if people fish, you know, effectively and intelligently, then you wouldn't break the rules.
And are you going to be on hand during people's stay?
On hand if they want me. I'm not. We don't live on site. Sharon and I are sort of 15 minutes up the road, 20 minutes up the road. So if you want me there 20 times a week to take photos because you're not comfortable with fish, or you want some great photos, or you know things like that, then I can be there anytime you want. If you want, you know, a week on your own with your mates, shut the gates and enjoy your week without me over your shoulder, then you can do that as well.
And finally, where can people find out more about who they contact to book the lake?
Okay, well, Sharon and I are the contacts for the lake, so availability, pricing, extras, all that sort of thing. So you can obviously visit lacdecoron.com, give us a call, all the details are at the end if that's easier, or join us on the Facebook or the Twitter pages, just search Lac du Coron and drop us a PM through there. We're always on hand to answer sort of emails and everything else, and as I say, all the details are at the end.
And just finally, just to sum up the lake in 3 words.
The lake in 3 words. Exciting, electric and chilled.
Thanks very much.